E oggi il popolo italiano e il regime fascista sono una unità compatta, infrangibile, formidabile, che può sfidare come sfida tutti i suoi nemici e anche il vantare del tempo.
By 1934, fascism was reaching out across Europe. In Germany, the Nazis were crushing what opposition remained. The Spanish socialists were determined not to go down without a struggle. They imagined there would soon be jackboots on the streets of Madrid if Theda and Hugo Robles took power. When Theda did join the government in October 1934, the Spanish socialists decided to strike back. Socrates Gómez was a member of the socialist youth.
Que había habido un proceso de regresión muy grave en la política española, y que estábamos y éramos conscientes.
We felt there'd been a serious regression in Spanish politics, and we were well aware that even without a civil war, fascism could come to power in Spain, perhaps camouflaged behind politicians such as Gil Robles. And this is what led us to strike. Planteamientos,
y eso nos aconsejó el ir al movimiento huelguístico.
You must realize that this wasn't just another strike for things like wages or better working conditions. This was a revolutionary strike, and our aim was to overthrow the government and take power.
The socialists summoned the workers to rise against the elected government, but the insurrection was easily defeated everywhere, except in the northern mining district of Asturias. There, the whole left for once united in rebellion. Socialists and anarchists, communists and Trotskyists seized control and declared the revolution. The coal miners shut down their pits and marched out eagerly to fight for Red Asturias.
We felt this tremendous excitement. We had dynamite ready to blow everything up, and everybody was behind us. The whole village was ready to go, even the kids, men, women, children, everybody.
It was open war against the Madrid government. The miners drove back local army units and murdered some of their political enemies. But the government now sent Moroccan troops and the Spanish Foreign Legion into the battle. A fortnight after it had begun, the Asturias Rising had been broken. The fighting had ravaged towns and villages. General Franco helped to plan the government campaign. As the army fought its way along the Asturian valleys, the defeated miners were shown no mercy.
The civil guard did it, and the army troops, and some of the local bosses who went with them pointing out suspects. They said, this one, that one. That was it. That's what happened. They killed all sorts of people.
Nearly 2,000 people were killed in the Asturias Revolution, some of them slaughtered in cold blood. Tens of thousands were marched off to prison. In Spain as a whole, the socialist-led rising had failed to get off the ground because the left could not act together. But the lesson of Asturian unity sank home. Over the next 2 years, the left drew closer together as the government imprisoned opposition leaders and demolished their reforms. In 1936, with elections approaching once more, most of the left united in a popular front. The anarchists did not join, but supported the popular front in order to rescue their own imprisoned supporters. On the right, Hugo Robles launched a noisy, confident campaign. He claimed that he alone stood between Spain and a murderous Bolshevik revolution. February the 16th, polling day, was a turning point in the history of Spain. As the results came in, it became clear that the Popular Front had won the largest block of seats. The release of political prisoners began. Dolores Ibarruri, known as La Pasinaria, had been elected as a communist MP for Asturias.
So then I went to the prison. The governor had run away, but his deputy was there. He said, "I haven't received any orders." I replied, "I'm the MP for Asturias." I was beginning to sound very grand. I said, "Please give me the keys. The prisoners are coming out today." He finally said, "Here they are." So I ran along the corridors of the jail, shouting, "Comrades, all out." It was very moving.
All Barcelona turned out for the return from prison of Luis Companys, Catalonia's president. The working class parties refused to join the government. The left Republicans were now trapped between the panic of conservative Spaniards and the excited hopes of the workers.